Hello, my name is Vibeke, and welcome to 5 Minutes About ADHD and Autism. Today I will show you one of my puppies. I have a couple of them running around my feet, and I want to show you this one because my pups can do everything and I will still just love them. They can pee on my floor, and they can eat my shoes, and they can do whatever they like, and I will love them even though. And I will take care of them in any way I can. I'm just shaking. I put him down. But it's somehow the same with our kids. When they are small, it doesn't matter that they say, "Oh, look at that fat man," or if they hit a mom, because it isn't that hard. He's so small. Who cares? It doesn't matter. But somehow we had to think about that. These dogs and these kids are getting bigger and bigger. They're somehow getting adults someday. And if we don't take care of all those small things which make it difficult for them to be in a new home or in a new place or in a new work, in a new way of being together with some people they didn't know before, if we don't help them while they are small and cute, we will give them lots of troubles later on. And maybe this video is especially for the teachers and those who is taking care of small kids, because in the society today we haven't got the time to take care of, not to hit somebody, not to yell, not to. We have, at least in Denmark, so few grown-ups, so few adults to so many kids, and there isn't time. We can help them if they are crying. We can say, "Please, you go over there. You go over there." But if we don't take the time and really help these kids with autism and ADHD, we give them so many troubles later on in their life. It's like we're pushing a mountain in front of them, and someday they have to climb it or stop moving forward. So I've been a teacher for kids with special needs for many years, and I have been a teacher for normally kids for years, and I have noticed by the last 10 years how it may not cost any money to raise kids with special needs in the school. So we teach them to do the math, to do the language, to do the writing, but we don't help them to argue. We don't help them to understand what it is to live a life without empathy. And we don't have time to tell the rest of the class what it is like to have ADHD and autism. And even though we think we can make them a part of the group, a good part of the group, where they feel comforted, when they feel they belong, and it is just not possible. If the class doesn't understand what it is to have ADHD, they cannot include it. They cannot accept it, and neither can we. If there's something we don't understand, can't just put it into our family. We can't just put it into our jobs. If my boss comes and tells me do that, and it doesn't make sense, and I just don't understand why I should do it, then I'm stressed and I'm frustrated. And it's exactly the same in the family with the siblings or in the school with the other kids. If they don't understand, they cannot accept it. And somehow the kids stop being just cute someday, like the puppies. So we had to raise them while we can. I had to, even though these puppies are so sweet, then I had to raise them. I had to say, "No, that's not allowed." And I had to say, "Yeah, good boy," when he's peeing on the grass. But it has to be like that. I can't just ignore it because, "Oh, I'm so tired," or it's because he has autism, I can't do it. We had to keep on finding the solutions, and if we can't do that ourselves, we had to ask for help. And and we had to ask or help each other as much as we can, because it is so important for the rest of the life for that boy or that girl with autism and ADHD, and actually for the pups too.